Experts are saying that after careful consideration, both the Moon and Pluto should be declared planets. What is good? This is Inform Overload. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and if you need a place to get your news on YouTube, hit the subscribe button and follow us on Instagram. Before I get into this video, tell me, what do you think? Should the Moon be considered a planet? Let me know down there in those comments. A team of astronomers wrote in the journal Icarus that they believe we should start calling our natural satellite, the Moon, a planet. This is obviously a pretty crazy thing. I mean, our Moon is literally called the Moon. Are we gonna have to start calling it Planet Moon? Because that's hella confusing, scientists. The exact rules about what makes a planet have been debated in the scientific community for a long time. The rules are actually pretty controversial, and not all scientists agree with them. This constant debate is what resulted in Pluto being stripped of its planet title back in 2006, after it was a textbook planet for 76 years. See, in the scientific community, there's this one governing body that makes decisions. It's called the International Astronomical Union. But just because this governing body makes decisions, that doesn't mean that all scientists agree with it. Scientists always disagree. It's part of being a scientist. So what makes a planet? According to the International Astronomical Union, a planet must orbit the Sun, be massive enough to pull itself into a sphere shape under its own gravity, and clear its neighborhood of debris and other celestial bodies, proving that it has gravitational dominance in its own corner of the solar system. Experts with the IAU argued that Pluto doesn't fit this criteria. First of all, Pluto is in the Kuiper Belt, which means it's surrounded by a ton of debris and it's not gravitationally dominant. So it was demoted to the status of a dwarf planet back in 2006, which is honestly like so depressing. Pluto was one of my favorite planets. Like, I mean, I didn't know Pluto personally, but I grew up learning that Pluto was a planet. And then all of a sudden, because these like scientists said it wasn't a planet anymore, it wasn't a planet anymore. Like, how does that work? But Philip Meitzger, planetary scientist at the University of Central Florida, doesn't agree with the rules that the IAU have laid out for planet criteria. He and his team argued that the third rule, the one about the planet needing to be gravitationally dominant in its neighborhood, should be omitted because it's not reflected in the consensus of past research. While looking at research papers that go back over 200 years, like to the 1800s, the researchers that published this study found that while most writers agreed that planets should be spheres and they should orbit the Sun, the whole rule about planets having to be the most gravitationally dominant in their system is only written in one paper from 1801. So the fact that the IAU is using that as criteria is pretty silly, and in fact a lot of scientists feel this way. According to principal investigator of the New Horizons spacecraft, the definition the IAU has set is sloppy science and it would never pass peer review. So with that, there's only two rules left. The Moon is definitely big enough to be spherical in shape. It's almost a quarter the size of our Earth. But that still leaves rule number two, where a planet has to orbit around a star. The Moon orbits around the Earth. Like, last time I checked, I'm pretty sure it orbits around the Earth, right? Joking. Oh my god.
Oh, you're stupid. It doesn't orbit around. Oh, you're so dumb, Charlotte. Of course it orbits around.
Yes, I know. It was a joke. Sarcasm. But hang on just a second. The Moon is not going to stay the way it is forever. The center of gravity between the Earth and the Moon is called the barycenter. It's what causes the Moon to orbit around the Earth. But the IAU says that there's been no official recognition that the location of the barycenter is involved with the definition of a satellite. Right now, the Moon's barycenter is inside the Earth. Over time, it's going to move outside the Earth because the Moon is slowly leaving the Earth's gravity at a rate of 3.8 centimeters per year or 1.5 inches per year. This will eventually, after a long time, change the center of our system's mass. This would then make our system, the system between the Earth and the Moon, a double planet system. The ancient Greeks thought that the Moon was a planet, and so did Galileo. When he observed the moons of Jupiter, he said that they were planets. According to history, round worlds that orbit other round worlds should be considered planets as well. This study will be published in the February 2019 issue of Icarus. Alrighty guys, that's all I have for you on that. It's time to do some comment replies. Comments. Raphael said, how do you guys earn money? Advertising? Doug Vanderhoop said, I love your Potato Queen channel. What are your thoughts on mashed potatoes? I think very fondly of mashed potatoes. They are quite delicious. I had some for lunch. Pearson Fan said, needed this after a stressful day. Well, you are welcome. Hope your day gets better. Totra said, do you have a speaking problem? No hate. I do not. But in order to make these videos funny, I gotta talk really fast, which makes me mess up more. We also don't practice our scripts before we film, so that would make me mess up less. But then you guys wouldn't have funny bloopers to watch, so. Trex Next said, watching this during school slash class. This is more important than my classwork. I feel like I'm gonna get some like angry messages in my inbox from concerned teachers and parents. That's okay. It's about the Moon. The Moon is science. Duh. This is educational. Edumacational. Welcome to the end screen. This means the video is over. Don't you worry, there's a link to a playlist right over here so you can go on an IO binge. And if you enjoyed your time here, smash the like, subscribe, and turn on notifications, and I will see you in a future IO video.